Do you need to receive payment in a foreign currency in order to keep certain customers? Well, then you need to know how to record receiving payment in a foreign currency. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Sometimes we need to receive payment in a foreign currency in order to have certain customers. We therefore must have a bank account that has funds in the currency of the other country. After the administrative tasks necessary to open an account with the other currency, you are then able to receive payments from customers who can only pay in their own home country's currency. When you receive payment from a customer into the foreign currency bank account, the currency has a specific value in US dollars on the day their payment is deposited. QuickBooks will remember the dollar value per unit for each of the units of the currency you receive. This value is from the exchange rate on the day the customer's payment was deposited into your foreign currency bank account. For example, let's imagine on February of 2021, we started doing business with Henry Goodman from Guyana. He pays us in Guyanese dollars, not US dollars. In order to service him, we must agree to receive payment from him in Guyanese dollars. Therefore, we must have an account in the First Bank of Guyana, which is an account in a bank in Guyana, in order to receive payment in Guyanese dollars and possess units of this currency. So from the main menu, we click List Chart of Accounts. Now we go to the bottom and we click Account New. Now, this is a bank type of account. We click Continue. And the currency will be one of the active currencies. So if you watch the prior video, you know that these were the currencies that we activated, and we will choose Guyanese dollar. And the name of it can be Bank of Guyana. And spelling doesn't count. Save and close. Now we're physically ready to receive Guyanese dollars. Don't forget that in our customer records, we already put Henry Goodman, and Henry Goodman accepts Guyanese dollars. We had already put that when we set up the file for the course. So let's do the example transaction. Let's imagine on February 8th, we did legal services for Henry Goodman for 10,000 Guyanese dollars. And made an invoice for him. The Guyana dollar at this moment, February 8th, is worth $0.005. Well, that should be easy. So, customer, create invoice. The customer is Henry Goodman, and the date was February 8th. And the service was legal services, and Henry Goodman gets paid in Guyanese dollars, 10,000. And now we must change the rate to be what we need it to be, 0.005 US dollars on exactly February 8th, 2021. That means that we are owed 50 US dollars for the 10,000 Guyana dollars that we are billing Henry for. And when we click Save and Close, you can see the trial balance reflects accounts receivable in Guyana dollars, 50, and income from legal fees has just increased by the 50 US dollars that is equivalent to the 10,000 Guyana dollars that we just billed Henry for. The most important thing to learn regarding multi-currency in QuickBooks is that the QuickBooks customer records will remember that accounts receivable Guyana has 10,000 units of currency, in this case, Guyana dollars, and each was promised to us at the moment that each one was equal to 0.005 of a US dollar. The most important thing to remember is that QuickBooks has this data about each unit of currency somewhere behind the scenes. You cannot check this, but you will see the results of this, and it will confirm that QuickBooks tracks all individual units of currency and what rate they were acquired at. Now, you will see a demonstration of this, and you will see the result. So let's continue with our example. Let's imagine on February 11, we received payment for the Henry Goodman invoice. Now let's imagine on February 11th that we only received 5,000 of the 10,000 Guyanese dollars listed on the invoice. At the moment the money was deposited from Henry into our Guyana dollars bank account on February 11, each Guyana dollar was worth 0.006 US dollars. So what's the gain? Well, the Guyana dollar was 0.005 at the moment we made the invoice, and now at the moment we're getting paid, the Guyana dollar is now worth 0.006. There is an increase per Guyana dollar of 0.001, and since we received 5,000 of the 10,000, that means the gain from this payment that we receive is $5. Five US dollars worth of Guyana dollars anyway. Five US dollars is the gain because it's 0.001 of a dollar times 5,000. So what will be the result after receiving the first 5,000 Guyana dollars? Well, we received half of what is owed to us. So accounts receivable Guyana will decrease from 50 to 25. However, we received 30 US dollars worth of Guyana dollars deposited into the bank account. So First Bank of Guyana will show up for the first time with a $30 balance because that is the US dollar equivalent of the 5,000 Guyana dollars we received at the moment the exchange rate was 0.006. And the $5 difference goes to exchange gain or loss. So instead of having a $3.70 debit, adding $5 on the credit side makes a net credit or a net gain of $1.30. These will be the numbers if we properly record this transaction. From the main menu, we click Customers, Receive Payment. The date of the payment is February 11th. The customer was Henry Goodman. Now, the exchange rate on the day we got paid is 0.006, and we only received 5,000 out of the 10,000 Guyana dollars. So we received 5,000 Guyana dollars and at the exchange rate of 0.006 on February 11th. And we click Save and Close. Oh, excuse me. The amount up here Got to put the same amount in the top of the window as the bottom. So you can see if the exchange rate is 0.006 and we receive 5,000, that we're getting the equivalent of 30 US dollars when we get the 5,000 Guyana dollars. Save and close, and the results are exactly as what we expected. Account receivable Guyana decreased by half, went down to 25 because we received half of the Guyana dollars. They were worth $30, and that's why our balance of the Bank of Guyana shows $30. And the difference was a $5 loss that was recorded here in exchange gain or loss. And if I double click, you can see the balance was a $3.70 debit. Then I made a credit of $5, making it a credit balance of $1.30. Now, to properly learn this, we have to follow through and finish our example. Let's imagine on February 15th, we received payment for the Henry Goodman invoice. We received the remaining 5,000 of the 10,000 Guyanese dollars listed on the invoice. At the moment the money was received from Henry, each Guyana dollar was worth 0.007 US dollars. So what was the gain? Well, the remaining 5,000 Guyana dollars on the open invoice are still valued by our QuickBooks at 0.005 per dollar, because QuickBooks remembers that was the value at the moment the invoice was made. The dollar is now 0.007 Guyana dollars. So the increase per Guyana dollar is 0.002 from the time that we made the invoice and the time we're getting paid these last 5,000. So if you take the increase per unit and multiply by how many units, you get the gain that we're going to have as a result of receiving the balance of the invoice several days later when the Guyana dollar has now increased by 0.002. So what will the result be after we receive payment on February 15th? Well, we received all of the money for the open invoice, so the accounts receivable Guyana should go down to zero. And the amount in US dollars of 5,000 units times 0.007 would mean we received 35 US dollars into our Guyana bank account, making the balance of the Bank of Guyana $65. And the difference between the $35 that increased our bank account and the $25 that was on the invoice is a $10 gain. So the net gain will increase by $10 and become $11.30. And these will be the numbers after receiving the February 15th payment where the Guyana dollar has increased. Let's take a look at how to record it. From the main menu, click Customers, Receive Payment. The date we received it was February 15th, a few days later. The customer was Henry Goodman, and we received 5,000 Guyana dollars into our account. Now, if it were only at 6, we would be receiving only 30, but it's not. It's at 7.007, exactly on February 15th, a few days later. So the amount of US dollars that we're receiving the equivalent of 35 US dollars on February 15th. When we click Save and Close, the results in the trial balance are exactly as what you would expect. The Bank of Guyana increased by $35 and became $65. Account receivable Guyana went down to zero because the invoice is completely paid, and the exchange gain increased to $11.30, and we can double click and we can see that this was the $10 gain from the payment on February 15th that increased the net gain from $1.30 to $11.30.